Hello everyone, we are under Volvo D13. This is the right side of the engine and this is the starter motor. So in our case this one is bad. It has a bad solenoid, sometimes it starts, sometimes it doesn't start, so we decided to remove and replace it. If you want to remove the starter motor, first you should disconnect the batteries, and after you'll disconnect the batteries you can start safely removing the wires from the starter. Usually it have two plus wires connected right here and the minus cable right there. As you can see, this one is the minus, is attached, it's coming from the battery, and sometimes it have one more that is going to the frame. In our case it doesn't, and two pluses connected right here. Also it have two small wires, these ones that are coming from the ignition, they are connected to this small solenoid right here. The one is connected to the top, another one on the bottom. You will have two 10 millimeter nuts, remove the nuts. Here is gonna be the 90 millimeter nut, and on the top is gonna be also 90 millimeter nut. After you removed all the wires, also sometimes it have a bracket right here and one bolt that is holding this small plastic bracket that are holding the wires together. You also should remove them, and after this you should remove three 18 millimeter nuts, one, two, and another one. I don't know if you can see, it's on the let me try to focus it. You can see just a small side of the bolt right there. Remove all the nuts. You can use a wrench key right here, you can use a wrench key right there, and you can use an extension with 18 millimeter socket. You can insert it from the back of the motor from here and you can loosen it. Let me show you. This is the extension and the key that the socket I used. You can introduce it from the back side and you will be able to go all the way to that nut and remove it. After you removed all the nuts and all the wires, you can remove the starter motor itself. You should just slide it forward, and after we can take it out.
Too hard for a Friday.
Who is this? Volvo guy?
Yeah.
Hello, how are you?
Good. Anything you guys need?
Looks like we're fine now.
All right.
Everything's good. Thank you very much.
Sounds good. We'll check back with you.
Yeah. Have a good day.
Yep. You too. Oh.
And this is our starter motor. This is how it looks.
Let me show you one more time. One wire goes right here, another one right here, two 10 millimeter nuts. 19 millimeter nut right here, two pluses. One minus right here, also 19 millimeter nut. One bracket that holds the wires right here, remove the bracket. And after, three 18 millimeter nuts around the starter motor housing. One, two, and three. This is how it looks inside, and sometimes you can find similar starter motor but will have different number of teeth, so it's not gonna work. Pay attention to the number of teeth, 9, 10, 11, 12 teeth. And now we can remove this bracket, install it on the new starter motor and put it back on the engine. And as you can see, this is where it goes, right there. This is our new starter motor it's Delco Remy. So what you should pay attention to is this small solenoid. Sometimes on there are a few kinds of starter motors where you can remove it and install it on another side if it doesn't fit, like between the frame and engine. On some of them you can install it right here. In this case we can't remove it, it goes only in one place, so make sure we have the same connections, everything looks the same. Remove the bracket and install it right here. Hey. Стрэнджел. Да и лягша звезд. As you can see, I just installed back the new starter motor. Now we're gonna put these three nuts around and tighten them well, and after we're gonna connect all the wires. Sometimes it's good to have long fingers. It helps a little bit. Or if you want, you can put it on the socket extension and you can just throw it from here and tighten it. This is what I'm gonna do on the last one because I don't have enough space to tighten it with my fingers. So I'm gonna drop the nut into the socket. I'm gonna use an extension. I'm gonna insert it from the back side of the starter motor and I'm gonna tighten it. That's it. This is what I'm gonna do right now, but first I'm gonna put some black tape inside the socket so the nut is gonna be tight. It's not gonna fall down, because like this, if I'm gonna do some vibration, it's gonna fall down. So I'm gonna use some black tape and after I'm gonna insert the nut so it's gonna be tight inside the socket. And now just bend it inside and put the nut. So it's gonna be, as you can see, we have black tape inside. It's holding it very well, so now I'm gonna insert it. I'll try to tighten it. Let's see what we can do. As you can see, in our case it worked out well. Oh, all three nuts are tightened. Now we can attach all the wires back. Remove this 10 millimeter nut, another one that goes on the top, and connect these two wires. This one with the red goes on the top. After, remove this nut, connect two pluses. You can see one plus, and this is another one. A minus right there, two pluses right here, and two wires from the ignition on this relay right here that goes near the solenoid. All these three 18mm nuts are tightened. Now we can go to connect the wires that goes to the battery. Now we're going to connect the batteries back and we will try to start some motors. Everything should work fine now. And also don't forget to clean all the connections if they are rusted, because some of our connections are very rusted, so we're gonna clean them now. We just replaced everything, we connected the batteries back, so now we'll try to start the truck. Formidable. Everything works fine. Let's do it one more time, just to make sure. The problem is solved. Everything works.